We're here at Club Paradise. And guess what I found? A longtime friend, Vanna Lace. Thanks for staying with us, Vanna.
Well, nice to see you again.
How long has it been?
Oh, I forget. I lost count. It was a while back in Pennsylvania.
Yeah, in Reading. Let's just say many moons ago.
Yeah, we were pen pals for a little bit.
We were. We even used to go shopping at the King of Prussia Mall.
Oh, my goodness.
Right?
Small world, isn't it?
So, what brought you here to Vegas?
I came out here to star in a show called Skin Tight at Harrah's Casino. I did that for a year. And before that, I'd done Miss Nude World.
I know you're Miss Nude World. You used to feature all around the
Travel, did the circuit.
United States.
You did that as well,
I
right?
I did, yes.
Model for Penthouse and won Entertainer of the Year, and I do hosting with Entertainment and Sports Today. And now I'm focused on burlesque. Burlesque
is... What is that?
It's sort of the art of striptease, and that's what I've been doing in L.A.
Really?
And here. It's a real movement going on around the country, especially L.A.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Vanna Lace.
Yeah. absolutely fabulous.
Fabulous?
Unbelievable.
Wow, put my breath on my head. She's still amazing.
Yeah. Oh my God.
We are definitely going to interview Zach right now.
Absolutely. Yes.
Let's go.
Let's go. We just want to show it's fabulous. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Yes.
If I could ask you, how long have you been doing this?
Probably about 14 years.
14 years.
So, yeah.
She might be
some experience.
You,
really.
Hold it. So you started when you're 6?
No, 2.
Wow. Amazing.
Yeah, but you know, it takes all that.
That.
You know?
So, go ahead.
I'm sorry, I just overwhelmed with the beauty around me. It was unbelievable.
That's all right. You're allowed. Was there anything else you wanted to ask? Could you quit looking at her bosoms?
No, I think yours is blocking my way.
Okay.
How many couch stands that you could think of right now that you did to a guy one time in one sitting? What's the most you ever did for a guy?
All night long.
Like, how many dances?
Oh, well, if you can, from let's say 9 o'clock till 6 o'clock in the morning.
Technically, like lap dances.
Well, they give you a little break once in a while, take a sip of water, but yeah, I mean, it can be exhausting.
Really.
I mean,
Nana?
Depends on what you do in the dance. I lift my leg up here and I bend over. And
I think you should try her out later.
Don't get me wrong, man. You're gorgeous.
Well, thank you, Bill.
If you sit on my lap for more than 10 hours.
Would you like me to demonstrate?
Not yet. I have something here. It's magnificent. Okay. This is August.
Come on, Billy, let's see it.
Of 2004.
Beautiful girl.
What do you think about Guy? Your first impression. Okay, I know guys come to the German club, they judge women. And some of the amateurs come in, they don't know what they want, and they sit down, they look around, they spend a little time. But for some of the experts, they come in for one reason only, and they have a certain type of girl that they want to do. So how do the girl critique the guy? Is a certain guy that
you mean,
roll
how does
for?
The girl pick the guy?
Hold it. How did the girl get to pick the guy?
Well, I thought you were asking, when a girl sees a crowded room of guys, who does she go up to first?
Exactly. See, a lot of girls want to go up to the guy, right, come in his suits and tie.
No.
No?
I beg to differ. I would go up to a blue collar when I was dancing.
Okay.
They were more easy to spend their money. Do you agree with that, Vanessa?
Las Vegas is different. Wouldn't you agree, Vanessa?
I haven't been dancing in Vegas that long, but I danced in Tokyo for about
in
8 years.
No way.
About 8 years. But maybe 60% of my customers were Japanese. but everyone else was, you know, international, from all over the place. I kind of, because I've been doing this so long, I get the vibe about who might like me. I don't look at how expensive is their shoes and the watch and the different things that you hear other girls say sometimes. well, if no one's looking at you, I guess. But yeah, you know, you've been doing it a while, you kind of get the feeling for, you just, across the room, this energy thing, and you know who likes you. So I try and pick the guy that's already a little smitten with me.
That's
and it's not
good.
About how he's dressed, for me.
Interesting.
Yeah. Okay. Were you expecting that answer?
No.
He wants to dance with you now.
I want to dance with anybody.
Let me see if I think he does.
Oh.
I personally don't think girls like when they dance for a guy who's kind of like Billy Wong. Octopus arms.
Hold it.
What do you girls think?
Excuse me.
I'm teasing, by the way.
He's the worst customer.
Worst customer?
Yeah. The octopus hands guy?
Yeah.
It's our nightmare.
How far will you let a customer go for a touching line?
Well, there's certain laws, but, you know, you try not to, like, go too far, but, you know, boobs in the face. I mean, there's, you're going to have to bleep this probably, but no sucking fucking or kissing, right? What is it?
What?
Champagne room.
Check, please. I'm out of here.
I think women are a lot easier to dance for. Don't you girls like to dance for women more sometimes just because it's a lot more comfortable? You can get away with touching them more. Yeah. For some reason, I don't know why, some reason it's overlooked.
You don't feel
Thank
violated.
God.
Yeah, you don't feel violated.
You don't, right.
You know, like with a man, it's like,
she is so unfair.
No, we try and push the envelope a little, but to stay within the rules. And I don't think that most of our customers are here to go so far.
Right.
It's more about the fantasy. Like, if you look at the quality of women that are here,
they're
we actually
obviously
develop,
not going to have that app.
And we develop, like, more of a relationship, like a good time and interaction and rapport. So when you're dealing with someone like that, on that level, it's not like they're gonna reach out and honk honk. I mean, that would just be silly, right?
You don't think so?
You never danced for Billy Wong yet.
And isn't this a more of a tee, just like
yes.
this on the knee or the inner thigh?
Yes.
It's more subtle,
more subtle and sensual. Yes.
Excuse me. When you ladies say tease, how far does this teasing go before you say, I think I don't need any more teasing?
Well,
who doesn't need more teasing? Them or us?
Oh, them. Absolutely.
Absolutely. It happened to me actually last week when a guy...
Yeah, give us that.
I didn't know what was happening, and I thought it was like his vibrator or something, you know, his phone.
Phone
and
vibrating?
In his pants. it really happened. I think it's the first time in my
career. So it does happen. Remember we were talking about that at the pool?
No, sleeping up. Yeah. This is going back. It's one of the clubs that I was in, at somewhere in the state. And I happened to know a manager there and a security person there. And there's one night I was walking in there while he was out there. He had a really sad look on his face. I say, let's call him Scott, because I'm on the phone. I say, Scott, what happened to you? He said, Bill, you don't want to know. I say, tell me. Okay. There was one customer who walked through. They have a metal detector. Uh-huh. Okay, they walked through. He beat. So he took out one of those hand wands that go over your body.
Right.
And the front was clear, everything was clear, but on the back, beep. The one on the back will beep, 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 beep. And now he's getting nervous, saying, what do you have back there? Whatever you have back there, any metal object, take it out. He's saying, no, I don't have nothing back there. You keep beeping. So more security came over. I was like, now it's like a situation.
A big situation.
He lifted up his his shirt, and I see a wire. He pulled out this thing that's about a yay big sofa, and he held it in his hand and looked at it. And for like 3 seconds, he didn't know what it is.
A butt plug?
Yes!
No! No way, really?
Yes.
I really haven't in all my career.
Now, for all those of you that can't get here to Vegas to see Vanna Lace, you can also see her at
www.vannalace.com.
I'm gonna go home and type in right now.
And I'll type in yours.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, so this is Vanessa. Vanessa, where can we see you at?
I'm currently working on a website. It's not ready yet, but you can still have a look. Watch as it's being created, www.fantasydates.com. There's a hyphen, fantasy-dates.com.
And that's where we can see you.
Perfect, yes. Perfect. We're looking
now,
forward to it.
I want to say thank you to Vanessa and Vanna.
And Club Paradise.
Hi, definitely Vanessa. Club Paradise. This has been great. Stay with us because we got a lot more places
lot
to
more
go.
Good.